Jude's never left. I never left. So we're driving now, we've got to sleep, so we come in the room about one. Yeah, this is the time for Dad's master. And now, you know,
to conclude our celebration of Christmas with this, the feast of the baptism of the Lord. It is a bit chilly. Good to see you wearing your coats, as the newsletter suggests. We've got a sort of double whammy, really. We've got the ventilation for COVID, and we've got that really annoying boiler down there that we reset it, it works. We get to Sunday, it fails. The engineer does keep looking at it, keep getting it going. The cost of replacement at the moment is probably prohibitive, probably looking at about £10,000. And we've got to factor in the other £700,000 worth of repairs to do over the parish. So that's a conversation that's ongoing with the diocese at the moment. We've got old buildings, they cost money. And these boilers, they heat the church for an hour. And there's a bit of a difficulty. We'll have to keep an eye on the situation. If it gets too cold, then we might be in the situation where we were last January, where we have to just say it's too cold in here and move to St Mary Magdalene for a week or two. But coats at the moment are the way forward. We're offering our Mass today for the repose of the soul of Cyril Hanson. Eternal rest granted to him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace.
Lord, have mercy.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
people here. And it has made salvation possible for the whole human race. And taught us that what we have to do is give up everything that does not lead to God. And all our worldly ambitions. We must be self-restrained and live good and religious lives here in this present world, while we are waiting in hope for the blessing which will come with the appearing of the glory of our great God and Saviour, Jesus Christ. He suffered himself for us in order to set us free from all wickedness and to purify the people so they could be his very own, would have no ambition except to do God. Correction, good. When the kindness and love of God, our Saviour for mankind, were revealed, it was not because he was concerned with any righteous actions which we might have done ourselves. It was for reason except his own compassion that he saved us by means of the cleansing water of rebirth, by renewing us with the Holy Spirit, which he has so generously poured over us through Jesus Christ our Saviour. He did this so that we should be justified by his grace, to become heirs looking forward to inheriting eternal life. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
us mark out the epiphany, the visit of the Magi, which we celebrated on the 6th of January, the baptism of the Lord today, and next Sunday we will hear the account of the changing of water into wine at the wedding at Cana. Our reading from Isaiah this morning is set amidst oppression. The Babylonians had conquered Jerusalem and deported the people into exile. But now, Cyrus, king of Persia, who himself has now conquered the Babylonians, is allowing the people to return home to Jerusalem. It's a new exodus. It's an announcement today that consoles the people. And for us, the gospel becomes the new book of consolation. Jesus Christ offering us that true consolation because he's not dealing with secular or worldly oppressions, but he's offering us freedom from our greatest foes, sin and death. And this prompts our song of joy. We lift up our voices to the Lord, and for us as an Easter people, Hallelujah, which we've just sung, is our song. We're about to return to ordinary time. This does not mean a boring or substandard time, but a period compatible with our baptismal dignity, that offering of consolation to the Lord's people. Now, in this era, God calls us to announce his word, to proclaim everywhere the good news of salvation and that promise of eternal life. But we too are on this pilgrimage home to the Father's house, which is found in heaven. St. Paul, writing to Titus, helps us see that we do not do this on our own. Christians share a common lifestyle, which is the fruit of grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit. And this fellowship is the cause of our joy. But it's also our inspiration to stay clear of sin and the near occasions of it. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the resurrection at the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. As always, Jesus remains our model. By means of grace, he instructs us on how to control our defects and to grow in virtue. That prayer that is prayed sometimes at the end of confession. May the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, whatever good you do, whatever suffering you endure, may this heal your sin, help you to grow in holiness, and reward you with eternal life. And so this then brings us to the feast of the baptism of the Lord as an expression of the Epiphany. Our Lord manifests his divinity, but also he shows his solidarity with humanity, that he will accept death, even on a cross, so that we may have life and have it to the full. Christ, being sinless, had no need of a baptism of repentance. That's what John was offering. But he undertakes John's baptism to reveal the mystery of the Trinity, which, of course, established the form of baptism for us, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And just in case, because it still crops up from time to time, any other formula of baptism is invalid. It does not confer the grace of baptism. And in doing so, when Christ reveals the Trinity, he's painting a new panorama for us. In his baptism, he's showing us that the old regime of sin that made humanity foolish, rebellious, and wayward, in other words, a slave to our passions, is set aside by the passion of Christ, which is re-presented before our very eyes this morning in the sacred liturgy. And we also, in this Mass, get a glimpse and foretaste of the heavenly banquet. Of course, baptism for us becomes the doorway, the gateway to salvation. It's a sacrament of regeneration, a sacrament of renewal. If you like, when you get to 21, you get the key to the door. Baptism is the spiritual equivalent, the key to the door of the Father's house. And indeed, like the baptism of the Lord, we become a child of God, all models on Christ Jesus. This is my beloved Son, my favour rests on him. So through Christ and through Christ's church, we learn the meaning of our earthly life, we discover the pledge of our eternal blessedness, that is a share of the life with the Blessed Trinity. And as we pray at the end of the Our Father, for the kingdom, the power and the glory, which is theirs now, may also be ours forever and ever. Amen. So in effect, we will renew our baptismal promises by using the baptismal symbol of the Roman Church, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Rather, we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make the last and eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John the Baptist, with St. Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard of Chichester, and with all the saints, on his constant intercession, in your presence, we rely on unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation to all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who have been to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, where we have to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow the world. All that is good. For all men are living and living, O Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. 2 o'clock on the Thursday, his funeral celebrated by Bishop Paul, one of the auxiliaries from Westminster, because Desmond was a Westminster priest. There's a vigil mass at 5 p.m. on the 19th of January, celebrated by our own Bishop, Bishop Richard. So that's at St. Thomas of Canterbury, 5 p.m. vigil mass, Wednesday the 19th, and a requiem at 2 p.m. on the 20th of January at St. Thomas of Canterbury. Any details of attendance, please go to the Good Shepherd Parish website, as I don't know what the arrangements are. We have also put on our website in the newsletter section an obituary for Father Desmond, written by Father Martin Hayes, who's the Vicar General of Westminster. Once again, wish you a very happy Christmas until the 25th of December this year. And we go to ordinary time, every blessing for ordinary time. Don't forget, please, before you leave, just to give your place a clean down on the fire of Christ. The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Yeah, that's fine. That's okay.
I'll see you later.
Yeah,
see you later.
Bye.